Hello everybody, welcome to Waji Rao and Reddy Institute, the best institute all over India, which gives you valuable advices and fruitful guidance to excel in all three modules of Indian Civil Services Examination. We are in this field since very long. Year after year and time after time, we have proven ourselves with best results and we have accomplished our goals by proving the number of successful candidates from our institute. In this order to lead our success story, we work as a team, we work hard, we work on all the parameters for this prestigious program related to UPSC examination. We make sure that our students work hard and they crack the riddle of UPSC. On that very special note, today we have ourselves with Dr. Professor D.P. Agarwal sir, who will tell us, and the person who does not need any introduction. He is beyond all the boundaries and introduction word itself needs an introduction. Let's begin with it. So it's our honor and privilege to welcome you here, sir.
Thank you.
And it's an honor for the student as well that they will be in your guidance. So I would like you to please give your guidance about UPSC and the prestigious exam. Please start, sir.
Good afternoon, friends. At the outset, let me all congratulate you for your work which enabled you to qualify both prelim and the main exam. And you are almost there, except the last leg of a three-stage competitive examination to become a senior civil servant in this country. You have already demonstrated perseverance. You have already demonstrated desire to succeed. And I thought the last leg you can walk through. If you notice, in the prelim exam, the rate of rejection is such that out of 6-8 lakh students appearing, you have 15,000 to 16,000 people qualify. So you can imagine the kind of rejection. You look at the main, from 15,000 to 16,000 to 2,500. So again, 1:6 kind of rejection. But when you look in terms of the personality test, which is the third component, it is only 1:2, 2.5. So you are in a much comfortable position and therefore there is no need to worry. I always tell my young students, having done so much of hard work, having get that confidence to be successful among many, many students, now why not to have confidence? I thought you have all opportunity to demonstrate only confidence. Let me say that. Firstly, there is nothing on earth which you have not studied. Your examination process, the main particularly, is such that you learn almost everything which is possible. And you are successful in the main, this clearly shows that not only you have learnt, you have assimilated, and you have articulated in writing. The difference now would come that now the UPSC wants to look at you and want to be sure that you possess a personality which in future would give to this country a very confident, sincere, articulative and honest civil servant whose main task would be to translate policies made by policymakers, which are generally elected representatives, for the benefit of people. And in the process, you also try to innovate in terms of process of implementation, in terms of creating an outreach of the program and the policy, so that bulk of the people get happy. Now, when you translate some of these policies of the government, you do meet a lot of people on the ground, and therefore, the time you spent with them and the understanding which you have of the society at large is useful for the policy maker. So, they also look from you the pulse of people. They want to also look from you what is the expectations of the society from the elected governments, which the policy makers account it when making new policy. UPSC has ensured that you learn the language, English as a mother tongue, and that you can articulate in the form of an essay, not only one subject, but at least two subjects covering social sector, economic sector, law and order, development. So, you have known how to articulate in writing. Then, through 4 general studies paper, you have tried to learn art and culture of this country. You learn the development, you learn the policies of the government both within and outside the world, the international linkages, the challenges, and what the future should lay of this country. You must also be aware that in last 10 to 15 years, technology has started playing a great role in terms of governance, and therefore, your awareness about the current technologies is almost a must. Today, computer is not a subject to be learnt by everybody. Everybody would know what computer is about. Each of you are exposed to using computer for information transformation, for interaction data processing. So, do not think if there are questions on computing, they are asking you computer science. This is required from any graduate who is currently ready to come to civil service. Accordingly, artificial intelligence, machine learning, they are becoming buzzword. If you are a regular newspaper reader, you can appreciate that not a single day goes when something or the other is not written on AI, not written on use of AI in terms of doing few things. Take for example, if I am going to make a policy, I must know what has happened in the past, and this data can be analyzed very well and predicted through AI tools and machine learning. And therefore, earlier times when you require sheets and sheets and hours, the work will finish very quickly. Similarly, each of us know that there is a 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G. These are the words which, if discussed with, I do not think you can say no. If you say no, that means you are not a citizen who is in tune with the government, and the today's government is a digital government. And in the digital world, some of these things are expected norms. In my opinion, having read so much, there is nothing special you have to read anymore. Continue with your reading newspaper, continue reading with your magazines. The only difference should lie that you should understand what a personality would mean. Personality of a person is not grown like we have for YOC of an interview, where we learn a subject, somebody asks me a few questions and I answer them. Personality test is built in you, and you already told UPSC through what you people call DEF, which I still call column number 17, which gives you all the information which allowed you to grow in your life. And this information consists of where were you born, where were you educated, which places you spent time, both as a student as well as a employee. Which schools did you go? What achievements did you have in your schools? So, all this you already declared. You have already told what your parents do. You have already told what are your interests. You have already mentioned what are your hobbies. So, what is that which is not known to UPSC? The point is not known is that in achieving your standards in school, achieving your standards in university, in debate or games, has it really made you a rounded personality? And therefore, what does board look at you? That can you understand an issue which the board want to discuss with you, comprehend it properly, and based on your knowledge which you had, and which I do not think can be added anymore, you have to plan your articulation and then answer the discussion point. So, mind you, it is not a rapid fire quiz question. Yes, sometimes the question would be such where the answer would be short, but there may be a question where answer may not be short, it will be little longer, but this only depends on the tenor and the style of the question. And therefore, what I said, it is important for everybody to listen the question very carefully. The way somebody puts your question, he or she may like to stress a particular point, they may not like to stress at all, and leave it to you know, to you to know what is that critical point which you must focus while you are articulating. And that requires listening carefully. So, first thing which you should do, listen question carefully, try to analyze question in your mind and collect your thoughts and start answering. There is no need to like a bullet, you can take your time, but it cannot be a 5-minute pause, because the total time given to you is 30 minutes and there are 5 experts. So, roughly 6 minutes to each, and if you take and pause 5 minutes, that means you are taking one's time. Your effort should be that the maximum number of questions should be asked to you. If you ask question in one area you do not know and you continue to waste time in that area, obviously you do not gain. So, my expectation from any time and when I appeared any of the interview, I always ensured that more and more questions are asked to me. So, that if not in one area, maybe in the second area, maybe the third area, maybe the fourth area or the fifth area, I am able to do better. So, question is that try to get as many as questions possible, do not be get frightened. More questions mean more opportunity for you to demonstrate your capability, your learning depth and your articulation process. So, listen question carefully, try to get more questions, that means your answer has to be up to the point, short, crisp, right, no rambling, no question asking can I guess, nobody is guessing around, either you know or you do not know. If you know, you yes, you answer. If you do not know, you say I do not know the answer. There is nothing wrong, because not everything you would know in earth. Because what is so different about this personality test, when they look at your personality, out of the information provided to you, they can pick up one point and start exploring with you, what did you learn from it? You spent time in university 3 years. Did you actually add something to your personality? How many lectures did you listen in the university from outside? What did you do? How did you participate in canteen? Did you participate in music? Did you participate in debate? Or you were just a bookworm? I have nothing against bookworms, but what is required? Tomorrow when you become a bureaucrat, you start meeting people, you start listening to them, you start trying to understand what they are saying. So, your understanding must have grown as a part of university learning. And then what university make you to learn, that you start learning in groups. And when you are the leader of a man, as a bureaucrat, you have to take a team along, and that learnability must come. So, there would be questions on leadership. Why not? Because if you were a prefect in your class, if you were a team leader in your class, what did you do? If they ask you a question, that tell us when you were a prefect in your class, what was the difficult situation you handled? They can ask you, you are in a canteen and somebody is fighting out, what would you do? They can ask you if you are on the road, you find something happening which is treacherous, your heart is attached to that, you want to be there. What are your actions? So, for a leader, how and what he should do? I am not frightened about asking question of something which is where does Taj Mahal comes in, because which I know, I can answer quickly. I can also answer quickly on what are the colors of my flag and what important they are. But yes, I must ask them, what does it mean to a bureaucrat? What does it mean to a nation? What does it mean to learn your constitution? And using your constitution, how can you help people to grow in this country? There are issues, the government make policies and nobody can stop government making policies. And this is a misinformation that UPSC try to learn from you whether the policy is right or wrong. That is not their task. Their task is only to know whether you understand the policy. Do you understand that what are the lacunae in the policy, if at all? And if you implement this, what are the challenges would come? And if you have an idea, new idea to improve the implementation of the policy, that they are interested. So, this feeling that can I say this or can I say that, I thought is incorrect position. Position simple, there is a policy, there is a thought process the government is saying, yes, the government is implementing them. You may have your own view and give your own view. The UPSC is not going to record your interview and try to give it to Mr. Prime Minister or to the health minister that this man has said so. Why are you scared? You are scared because you really don't know what to say. To be saying correct thing, you should be knowing facts, you should prepared well, and you should know in and out of a problem. If somebody asks you whether the budget of government of India in health is good enough, you might say may not be good enough, but then this is not the sufficient answer. You must know why it is not good enough, where it has been better than this, and if it become better, what and how it will be utilized. So, it is an all round understanding on issue. If somebody says what are the problems in Delhi, you can count any problem. Somebody who is suffering day in day out, he might say water is a problem, other might say electricity is a problem, third might say traveling in Delhi could be a problem, law and order could be a problem. But whatever problem you take up in your plate, you should understand why have you taken that as a problem. And if this problem exists, what one or two possible solutions you have before you? Can you think something new which is not happening? Government is already doing a lot of things, both center and state. I mean, they are there to do few things and they all are doing. Some of them are successful, some of them are not. But it does not mean that the governments don't do. All that you have to understand, whether the way the government work and perceive reaches to the people, and if it does not reach, what suggestions you have. You cannot say, sir, there is a lot of bungling in the fair price shops. Yes, if it is there, what did you do? Did you complain? Did you go to the police? How many time you spent in the line? How many time did you go to the ration? And if you are a citizen, which is you find there is a problem, did you report to the government? So, did you act as a good citizen? But yes, you might also have an idea. They can ask you, tell us, how would you improve if tomorrow you become a collector? Similarly, there are elections and everybody is worried. People keep on thinking voting percentage is critical. Why not everybody should vote? And they ask you, tell us what will happen? How would you ensure? People talk about corruption in election. How would you reduce? So, the issue would be in depth. As I said, there would be more than one expert there. And each one like to discuss. Each one not ask you questions, one question, then the second question, third in a different area, third in the different area, fourth in another different area. It is unlikely to happen. He might start with a simple question, but he might end up in a very difficult question. Difficult question is to you who has not understood the whole issue. The other question which people unnecessarily keep on worrying, UPSC, what UPSC expects? What UPSC would expect? They would expect you to perform well. They will expect you to understand the question and and responded accordingly in a positive frame of mind, understanding that if you are not able to answer correctly, are you receptive to a new idea, and based on the receptive new idea, can you articulate? So, the problem is not anybody else, problem is within you, that you are so fearful that you do not know anything. Having studied so much, I do not think there is a question that you do not know. So, what is the best course? The best course is, try to collect your thoughts once again, try to understand what ails the country, what has problems and benefits which you drew as you grew in your life. For example, if you were a student coming from a district in Uttar Pradesh or Bihar or maybe in Karnataka, and just they want to know it from you, what do you think the district has qualities? If somebody come to your district and if you are a guide, what will you do to make this person to come again and again? A very simple question, but you like to tell both history and culture, you like to tell the strength of the district in terms of production, industry, the law and order situation. So, the places where you lived, it is fair expectation that they should know what your reaction on them. I also understand that sometimes you do a school, you never go back to the same town, but yes, you can recall what happened to you when you were a student there, and you are supposed to keep in keen interest in wherever you lived. UPSC has already declared in the gazette, where they say personality test, and they said each candidate is required to have a keen interest in the activities and the events occurring around you day in day out. So, event can be somebody, you can see a fight around, event can be you can see a road working, event can be a new train line is been put up, event can be a new water setup has been created, event could be a new water supply system has been created in your thing, including you must have seen an election around, and you can see the problem in election and going to the booth. So, there can be any kinds of problem, and when somebody as a civil servant having done 4 courses in general studies, you can divide the social milieu in which you have lived, in which you have grown, the hobby which you have. After all, why do you have a hobby? Hobby generally is learning beyond your school, understanding few things which interest you more. Sometimes you come to education because your parents wants you to become physicist or a mathematician or a chemist or an engineer or a doctor, but your heart lies to play cricket, or you like to listen to commentary, or you want to be a good musician, or you want to be a good photographer, or you want to be a good writer. Now, hobbies generally are done in those areas which otherwise is not becoming possible. In hobbies, there is no exam, but in that learning therefore, must be more enjoyable, and they want to understand that enjoyment which you had in that hobby. But you are then expected, you enjoy that hobby, you should know all technicalities. If you are taking photograph, and they will say the photography have changed, you should know how the photography have changed. Today in a camera with 5, today in a mobile with 5 cameras on, you can compose a photograph, which otherwise used to be very difficult. You should know what an XLR camera is and all that kind of things. So, hobby allows you to learn in a much interesting atmosphere, and therefore, your knowledge base is better, your interest is there. So, there is nothing wrong, and there may also not be a question on hobby at all. You might come into the boardroom and they can start asking question anywhere. It is not written that.
Sir, as we are talking about hobby, some student thinks that if they share a certain hobby and that is not a special hobby, then how the board member will take it?
No,
they should share or
no, not? Whatever they have said, they have said. He can ask, and if they don't do anything, he can say, no, I have not done. Now, there is nothing special hobby there. The UPSC does not write a list of hobbies. UPSC has never written any list of hobbies. It is your hobby. If you don't have a hobby, say, I don't have an hobby. You must be honest. The problem lies that you are dishonest saying, I have this hobby, and If you ask here two questions, you don't know anything. That means you are trying to fool people out. So people who are dishonest would be a sufferer. So I would always recommend, don't be a dishonest person. Honesty is the best thing which you basically look. Because they want to look at the best of the people coming to this country who are not only honest but also know the subjects. They are not looking at you, they are not looking at your father or a mother, they are not looking whether your father is a rich man or a poor, they are not looking in you or whether your father is a civil servant or a politician. That information they are not interested. Don't even try to bring these issues. It is you whom they are talking to. So UPSC is very clear that they want to select the best person and they give you a best opportunity. The questions put into you in a much more confident manner, in a manner in which you are not harassed, in a manner which in a much most friendly manner, in a manner in which you are given an opportunity to understand the question and speak. So scope is there with you. You want to sunk yourself, you do. Speak lies, throw names. Who is interested to know whether you are known to XYZ minister? Will it matter? It doesn't matter. You all know that the members in chair of the UPSC are appointed as a constitutional body and nobody can do anything with them. And they are not agent of anybody. They are people, and all of us know why UPSC is created. UPSC is created to select unbiasedly very quality people to civil service. The constitution itself gives them that guarantee, and therefore you should have faith that if you are good, you will always get good marks. But personality is built over the year. You can be asked any question. If you have done, you have won some awards in Tirandaji, and today if you ask a question on Tirandaji and you are not able to answer, this doesn't look good because you got some award. So that means you tend to forget what you did you get. Can you forget it? You don't know the vice chancellor name of the university where you studied. Tomorrow you forget the name of the chief minister and the prime minister itself. That means you only go along with people who are with power. And that's not what we are looking for. We are looking for what has built your personality. You should know you are in university. If you are in Delhi University, some very eminent person is a vice chancellor. So you should know who are the eminent people in this country, and vice chancellor is definitely one. The professor which has taught to you has built your life, and you don't know who taught you physics, who taught you chemistry or philosophy. You tend to forget what did you study in the last semester. You tend to forget what projects you do. Can you do that? Tomorrow you will forget who is your mother, your father. Why should you remember your friend's name if you tend to forget who taught you physics in your final year? Why should you know your friends? So today you will make some friend, tomorrow you make another friend, you forget all your friends. So this tendency of not to know things which you have done, which is a part of personality. After all, I spent my one semester with my physics teacher, and can I forget him ever? He has a style of teaching, he has a style of interaction, he has given me marks, he has failed me or he has made me. Can I forget? I cannot. So this question that said, I don't know. They are not going to ask you that, are you a good collector, because you have not become a collector yet. He is not going to ask you, who is your model collector, why should they ask you? Even if they ask you, they will ask you, why his personality is so good. He is a good planner, he is a good speaker, his communications are better, he is an efficient man, he tries to meet people, he assimilate people, he develops confidence, he is honest, he does not use the power. So these are characteristics. Do you have those characteristics? Now if you ask me, is it what the UPSC would desire? I thought each personality should be that. You should be honest, you should be compassionate, you must know when you are around in your area, can you think that? I mean, that is what I want, an observant person, a person who can communicate, a person who can honestly think. And all that, the knowledge which is around you, using that knowledge, can you solve the problem? And that you have to convince this board that yes, I have tools with me, I have communication with me, I have a desire to do, and I am an honest man. What else will you do? They can ask you a question, yes, if you have done a thesis in your master's program or a BTech program, if they ask you what is your thesis, is there something wrong? After all, you spend full 6 months in 1 year to complete a thesis. Thesis is nothing but in-depth study of a given topic. Maybe this topic is so important in future in this country. After all, some people have done thesis on AI, some people have done thesis on the new programming language, some people have done thesis on 3G, 4G. After all, they have been assimilated in public. Some people are doing how to save electricity. After all, the new bulbs have come. So, everything which you have done in learning is useful, if not today, but tomorrow. So, this whole question of denigrating of your own personality of studies from school to university is a stupidity, because it is where you have learned. You first time met a teacher, you love him or her, first time she told you how to interact, you met your young friends, you became successful, moved ahead, you achieved high standards. So, you are an achiever. An achiever is something different. So, the personality of an achiever, as I mentioned, would be one who understand the problems around, who have tools with him or her, and who can utilize them to solve for them and understand the possible solution. You are not a messiah. Please understand, I am not saying you are a lord or you are a Bhagwan. Only with these tools and understanding, you are able to implement some of the policies. And then you are able to do mid-course correction, and you are able to bring people's feedback back to the government. I think, in my opinion, that constitute. Sometimes people ask me this question, how do I look? How would I look when I dressed in a suit? Or to me, that's not important. It was never important for me. And I don't think it is important to anybody. What is important to everybody is that what you are, you should look. It's the summer time, April interviews start, April, May, Delhi touches 45, you wear a suit which is not yours, because you are not, you coming from a district where it's also hot, you don't even have a sweater, and you suddenly wear a suit, you are perspiring, you don't know how to wear a tie, so you are holding your tie every day. So, your time is spent. So, when you are in the board, if you are looking still, your how do I look, I think you are doing something wrong with you. You should look pleasant. You should wear untorn, clean cloth. You should have a reasonable dress, because after all, you are meeting people who are so superior in their lives. And we all know, our homes have told, parents have told, when you go and meet a certain person, go well dressed, and whatever dress suits you better is better. But you don't go in a half shirt. Do you go in a half pant? You never go. So, obviously, somebody will wear a trouser. If you can't go to meet your mama in your half pants, if you are a grown up child, or you meet your father-in-law, then you can't go to the board, definitely. This board is a very formal board of very important people, highly acknowledged people of this country. They are not nobodies, they are very top people. And we want to go to meet them people, the first impression is that you are a polite, smiley, good gentleman, nicely come and looks pleasant. That's it. You are not going to give an image of a shabby person whose hairs are thrown around, but you are also not looking a stylish. You are going to Javed Habib and get your hair style done, because they also got your other photographs. So, the idea is, remain what you are. Wear nice dress, good dress. It's not a Govinda dress where you have a red t-shirt and yellow pant. Yes, there are standard things. Everybody wear a normal dress, like a normal shirt, blue or green, and not in black and red. But they won't ask you a question at all. Why should they ask you a question? Whether you wear a trouser or shirt, they will look at you. That's it. They will make their own mental notes. Similar question people ask me, sir, shall I make my hands here and there? You can't gesture if you are not made to have gestures. Gestures only come as you grow. More confidence you have, more gestures start, because then you are trying to explain few things. Here you are just a young person, you are not getting to the art of gesturing, you are in the art of only explaining, and that means your eye to eye contact in a very calm voice, you should be able to answer. Gesture can do. Bajpayee ji could do gestures because he is a life example of himself. Modi ji can do it because he has a life experience. I can do it because I spend my life. But if you do this to the board, they know you are still a young man, you are just still trying to understand. So be as you are. Speak the same language you speak with your friends in your classes. Don't be too accent. People who speak English try to start speaking in accent. Why do you speak in accent? As if you are coming from America today. English is not spoken in America. English is also spoken in this country, and that too correct grammatical. So speak grammatically correct English. No shortcuts, no syllable, and no what you call is the slangs. Because with the board you can't use slangs. So idea is dress well, which suits you, in which you are comfortable, number one. Number two, be what you are. If you can smile, you smile. If you can't smile, you don't weep, so you will not weep, I am sure. You will not be angry on the board, so your anger will not be there. You have to be calm, you have to be quiet, you have to listen to the question carefully, you have gone there. You are not to be scared, they are not troubling you, they are not pulling your legs, they are very friendly people, but they are knowledgeable people. They don't like you to telling lies them, they don't like you trying to bluff them. You can't get away with bluffing. If you bluff, they will catch you straight away. And once you bluff, they will not put in a word, but you are done, you are doomed. Sometimes people try to tell me, sir, last time I got more mark in personality, my personality has not changed. Maybe this time you are more anxious and you try to bluff. Maybe this time you are more anxious, therefore you are not as confident, because last time you were not selected. So you remain the same, information remains same, except 1 year has passed, and in 1 year new activities has occurred, country has moved, GDP has grown, scientific achievements have been there, there is a lot more peace in the country. So a lot of things has done. So your personality is nothing but you interact with the environment. So it is not VOC, it is not interview. So your personality has changed last year, because till last year you have made two attempts, in one attempt you have not been selected. In one attempt you were not even qualified. So this is a big change. So people telling me, I have not changed much, you have changed every day. Maybe last year you were doing another coaching, this time you are doing another coaching. Maybe this last time another paper, this time another paper. Last time there were less fear, this time more fear. So the problem is that nothing is static. The country is moving forward. The demand and needs on bureaucrats are changing every day. Society's expectations changing every day. Till Corona was not there last year, so everything changed last year. Again, suddenly when interviews are coming, Corona is again showing it up. Is it not a big change? So personality is not asking question only on what you have given them information. They can't ask you anything on earth, because you have said you want to become a bureaucrat in this country. And bureaucrats in their lifetime move from one department to another department to third department, the fourth, and they can't say, I won't go join there. Today they can be education, and tomorrow they can be animal husbandry. So that is the kind of comprehension of issues in learning you must demonstrate. It is neither the dress, it is not the expectation. Because UPSC has not hidden anything. They have already given, declared in very simple terms, repeat again. It is that a candidate must take interest in the events around him and have his own views and ideas on each of them. Many things in technology has become public discourse. So whether you are a Sanskrit student or a philosophy student, asking a question in AI is not a technical question. Asking a question on 4G and 5G is not a technical question. Asking a question on social media is not a technical anymore. Photography, in fact, is not a technology anymore. So please expect that there can be questions related to health. During Corona time, so much have been spoken about the vaccination, the medicines. I think every day there is something in the newspaper. Doctors are speaking. So when you look at the social media, when you read the magazines, they not only cover social science, they cover achievements in medicine, they cover achievements in science technology, they cover achievements in industry. In Corona, industry suffered, but the new product has come. So, idea is understand that the governance and administration will have to deal society, will have to deal development, will have to deal international relationships, will have to deal future growth of the country, will have to deal what is called inclusiveness, and that would mean that you can divide the whole administration and discussion into multi points. There would be a situation on law and order, there can be situation women empowerment, there can be situation women at work, there can be a situation on child development, there can be a situation on the monetary benefits for inclusiveness, there could be new education policy, what not. It is up to you to divide the whole administrative issues into small element. So, my last mantra would be that each of you should plan to divide your learning, which you have done over the time, into at least 12 to 15 sectors. And the best way to prepare that you ask as many questions as you can. After the board asks you questions, they ask you questions based on their understanding. They also ask questions based on what they have faced in their lives. Whatever preparations you have done, whatever you think of this country and the country's relation, whatever you think of inclusiveness and the social assimilation, you should ask questions in each of these sectors. Ask at least 50 questions, answer yourself and get satisfied yourself. You are not satisfying anybody. You can come outside and say, my interview was very good. Who knows what did you say inside? It is only your confidence in your success within you. And I am sure most of the good candidates know that if they are satisfied within when they are answering, it comes loud and clear that they are answering correctly and critically right. So, develop that confidence that you can assess yourself rightly in not one sector but 15 sectors, and you can ask in each sector 50 questions going from a simple question to difficult question in a chain of questions 6 to 8. I think you are done. Any other thing is misleading. You must have confidence because the competition is now very small. It is also possible that you have done so much good in writing that even you get less marks here, you can still be selected in the top ranks. So, to that extent, this elimination is not known to anybody. People are also not aware how many marks you got in written. So, it is a different set of examination and you will get some marks in it and these marks will be added. So, it is quite possible that written marks are too good. Here you might get less marks, but you still selected. So, it is not end of life here. So, end of life. So, do not blame if you are not selected because the interview is not good. It is the culmination of the marks in the mains as well as marks here put together gets your merit. I wish you very best, friends. I try to dissuade to spend your time unnecessary things. Develop confidence, articulate the way I have said, get the practice of understanding question, try to get the depth of the question and try to answer. You have learned a lot, now you have to only assimilate and comprehend. Thank you.
Sir, as I mentioned that it's our honor and students' honor that you are guiding us, I just want to know, sir, that as you were mentioning that change is very important and we all are suffering from coronavirus. So, the pattern before coronavirus was different of questions. Now, there should be a change in the pattern or students should be prepared that way.
So, why should they be different? The only change is that main society is the corona impact. So, some questions can be on that.
Sir, some students...
If GDP has gone down, if somebody is explaining, for other reasons would be corona. But that's not the complete story. So, GDP development, GDP, economic development, social law,
yeah.
These are issues. They are not only corona issues.
So some students.
So please don't try to tell them that the questions are governed by event which is occurring now, right?
True.
They are culmination of many points. Let them with open mind. Let them go with complete open mind.
So some students are confused about the situational questions.
There are no situational questions. The questions are meant for issues which are to be grown.
When they are into corporate services and they are changing to administration.
Obviously, that he has to answer. Why is he leaving? Neither you can answer nor I can answer. Can I?
No, sir.
He must decide why he is coming.
So there are no situations.
If he is so unhappy in corporate sector or he was not getting that kick, let him say so. He has to answer. How do you?
Exactly.
You are not in the corporate sector. If you are corporate sector, then you got to leave and do teaching. You tell them. Why did you go?
Okay, thank you so much, sir, for being here and for our students. You have guided us so well. Thank you so much.
Thank you. My pleasure.